Hello and welcome to Downtown Alive, presented by the Reading Downtown Improvement District. I'm your host, Laura Reppert, the Special Events Coordinator for the Improvement District. The Improvement District stretches from 2nd to 11th along Penn Street and as far out as Chestnut and Elm in some places. We're focused on creating a vital, productive, and commercially active environment in downtown Reading. This is achieved through our Safe, Clean, and Green initiatives, a number of events that we host downtown, and working with downtown businesses. And today we have an owner of one of those downtown businesses. Mi Casa, Su Casa is located at 320 Penn Street. And we have owner Johanny Cepeda-Freytiz with us here today. Welcome, Johanny.
Thank you. Hi, Lauren. Thank you for having me.
Yeah. So, Johanny, Mi Casa, Su Casa seems to be everywhere. If it's at the Penn Street Market, one of the midday cafes, Downtown Alive, you do the Caliente Night over at the Crown Plaza as well, and you do private parties too.
Correct. Yep. A lot of catering.
How do you keep up with all of that?
I take vitamins. No, I'm just kidding. You know, I have to say I've been blessed with a great family, great friends, great support system, so we just managed to make it all happen. You know, and it's just about coordinating, time management, organizing, and just executing. Sometimes things don't always go my way. I'm real particular. I'm anal. My husband will tell you I drive him crazy. But nonetheless, our goal is that I'm a perfectionist, right?
Yes.
Which is a flaw. Anyhow, our goal is to make it happen, make sure that we're providing quality service. We're making people feel welcomed, comfortable, happy, and tummies full.
Great. So with some of that, the events that you're putting on, you're saying to be perfectionist, that has grown over the past 10 years. Because we are celebrating your 10-year anniversary,
I think. Yeah, we celebrated it yesterday.
Saturday would be the day.
October 7th is the anniversary, yes.
So tell us a little bit about how you got started and what those last 10 years have been. And
wow. So it's been, I'm actually physically exhausted. No. Oh,
can't tell.
But nonetheless, excited, happy, because it's such a huge milestone. Mm-hmm. So Mi Casa, Su Casa is like my third child, my baby. So my baby's now 10 years old, you know, very big. How did we get started? Wow. I remember, well, first of all, let me backtrack a little bit because I've been visiting Reading since I was about 16 years old.
Okay.
I have a ton of family here in Reading. And so, you know, then as a grown adult with children, married, etc., I remember visiting my cousins, and they had Café di Gemelli, which is now Mi Casa Su Casa.
Okay.
And my cousins, I don't know if you've heard my story, but I used to live with them in the Dominican Republic. And we had made a pact at the early age of about 12 that someday we would be in business together, but it was going to be like fashion design world, right? It didn't turn out that way. Anywho, my son was, gosh, not even a year old. No, he was a year old already when I came to visit the establishment. And I was just like, oh my gosh, you girls started without me. And then the opportunity presented itself. They had closed. They were ready to, you know, they were going to sell their property. It was a closed shop in the downtown area. And yeah, the opportunity presented itself. I was like, you know what? You know, I'm missing out on my children because living in New York City, working, I mean, the train ride alone to work is about an hour. So my point is, I would miss out on my babies. I would leave them sleeping, find them sleeping, and I knew something had to give and change. So I chose to just be my own boss, be my own, you know, be an entrepreneur, and have the flexibility to have my kids around me. You know, I could bring them to work. So that's how it all began. I always say that Mi Casa Su Casa found me. Right. This business found me because it was just everything. You know, I'm a woman of faith. I pray. And then, you know, God in mysterious ways will set, you know, send me hints, open up doors, give me a wink. And here I am 10 years later. And it's been interesting. It's a great experience. Lots of challenges. Right. I mean, it wasn't always peachy because when I opened my business, it was in 2007. And I don't know if you recall, but in 2008, the economy crashed.
Yeah.
So that was devastating. And it took me years to recover from that. And sometimes I'm still haunted by that. You know what I mean? I'm in a better place. I've survived. And now just it's a matter of now, you know, making a profit because I'm kind of tired of sustaining. Now it's time to take things to the next level. And, you know, we have some projects coming up.
That was something else I wanted to talk to you about. So you've been on Penn Street for 10 years, and you've seen things evolve, and your business obviously is evolving as well. And I know you have some new programs coming up.
Yes.
So you want to tell us a little bit about those?
So we finally remodeled our back room, our backspace, and we've turned it into a classroom. And we're going to be teaching cooking classes. So our goal is to explore culture through culinary arts. So very excited to get that started. You know, check soon, follow our Facebook page for classes. We also, I've partnered up with my cousins, the ones who I bought the business from, and they are certified instructors for the
Serve Safe.
Yes, that's Serve Safe. Safe Serve. I always get them the wording. In any case, so they will be teaching courses there, so people who need to get their food handling certificates, they can come to Mi Casa Su Casa at 320 Penn Street, register, and the class for that will be, they have about three classes because they have in English and Spanish.
In English and Spanish, and you'll be offering that multiple times during the year, which will be a great resource for restaurant owners or chefs in the city.
Yes, you know, and it's accessible, we have parking, so it just makes sense, you know? So our, you know, like, you know, Laura.
Yes.
Our business is more than a business. It's a community hub, right? So I always say, you know, when you come to Mi Casa Su Casa, we're not only filling your tummy, but we're stimulating you visually because of the arts and also the ambiance. We, you know, our goal is to kind of like fill your mind, body, and soul.
Right. Yeah, so if you want to talk a little about that, because I noticed you always have rotating artwork.
Yes.
In the cafe as well. So how does that work? How do you
Well, so I used to work with Ed Terrell. He used to be my art curator, so every month the artwork got changed, however. Ed Terrell has left. He moved away. And so what's remaining on my walls is actually my children's artwork.
Oh, your children's artwork.
Yeah, okay. So every year when my children come home from school with their artwork or art projects that they've done in school, I just have them framed and I put them up. So they beautify the space. They've been like the most permanent display, art display at my restaurant. So I'm looking to, you know, see what artists I can connect with that can kind of like take on that responsibility.
Gotcha.
You know, just changing up the art and, yeah, because Mr. Chavel would just put it up, display, work with the artists, would find different artists to showcase every month. So it was pretty neat. I never knew what to expect. I just saw it when it was on the wall.
Yeah.
You know, and again, I'm that type of entrepreneur, so I like to give opportunities. You know, as long as they're positive and win-win, let's do it. Let's go for it.
Yeah. And also along the lines of the opportunities. So at your 10-year anniversary party last evening, it was also a mixer for networking.
That's
and that's one of the other things that you host at the Mi Casa Su Casa as well.
Yes.
And is that something you partner with the chamber to do? Am I correct in
understanding when it originally started was with Giovanni Bedoya. So he has a company called Red Tie Affairs. And so when he came up with this idea of what he wanted to do, we met and I said, sure, why not? Let's make it happen. And the first one was two years ago, May 2015.
Okay.
You know, it was like the launch of this mixer and look what it's become. So every, So now the Greater Reading Chamber has adopted it. And so, you know, they support it. And every first Wednesday of every month, there's a diversity mixer networking event. And it takes place at different locations every month.
Okay.
Which is neat because then people get exposed to different
venues. Yeah, they get to see different venues. And then you also host open mics and music occasionally as well in the cafe?
Every so often. However, since my catering business has grown, I mean, I'm almost booked like weekends doing whether it's 316, weddings, an array of events. I've kind of paused a little bit on the open mics because I'm just not available. And so we're looking to reconvene. You know, and I like to partner with, obviously, my business neighbors. So I'm looking forward to partnering with Brad Waples. He owns Custom Ink Printing right around the corner. And so I know he wants to like kind of like get started the first Fridays again. We used to do those back in the days as well. You know, and a series of you know, the a series of events and activities. So Brad, I'm sure, will be announcing what he's going to be doing soon. And so, yeah, I mean, we want to revitalize the downtown area. We've realized that there is a need for some type of nightlife and some foot traffic. Right? We need more life.
For sure, yeah.
So whatever I can't do on the street, obviously you're going to get that when you come inside my restaurant.
So it'd be wrong in saying that if a community member had an idea for some sort of thing downtown or something that they feel that their space could be used at, that you're very approachable.
Oh, absolutely.
As far as come on in.
Let's make it happen.
Have a pastelillo,
I just can't do it all.
Pitch it to you.
So if you're, you know, and that's how we initiated our open mics. It was a group of young adults, when I first opened, they saw the space and they were blown away. And they said, oh my gosh, this would be a great location for open mics. And I said, if you help me pull it together, no problem. I will open up and we'll make it happen. So I'm always looking to explore different opportunities and, you know, and keep enhancing what we're already doing at Mi Casa Su Casa.
All right. So you hear that. So if you stop down to Mi Casa Su Casa and you've got an idea at 320 Penn Street, yes, you'll only be fed really delicious food, and then you'll have some great conversation. You can connect with Johanny. And Johanny, what are some events that you have coming up where people can check you out as well outside of the restaurant?
So tonight, right, I will be at Calientes Night at the Crown Plaza Hotel. We're there every Thursday beginning at 6 p.m. It's all you can eat Latin food, and it includes a beverage for $12. You can't beat that. Thursday you will find us at Calientes. There's also, you know, it's an experience. Mm-hmm. There's dancing, there's dance classes as well. It's a great event. You know, you can, like, eat all you want and then burn it off on the dance floor. I mean, it can't get better than that. You know, and then you'll find us at different venues and events. That's what I have so far at the moment. And like I said, I'm always looking for opportunities. So anyone who wants to make something happen, you just come see me. And if I can't do it, then we'll find someone that can.
Great. Yeah. Thanks, Johanny. Mm-hmm. And congratulations on 10
thank
years.
Thank you. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Yeah. So speaking of some of the events that are happening in the city, there are a number of things coming up in October. And the first one of those is the Penn Street Market Harvest Festival. So this is an event that's a culmination of the end of the Penn Street Market season. It's held at Oakbrook Brewery from 5 to 9 p.m. And that's at 628 Park Avenue off of Lancaster Avenue. It's a family-friendly event that's going to feature live music, delicious food, unique cocktails, and local beer. And the first 100 people to arrive were going to receive a free 32-ounce growler, compliments of Oakbrook Brewery. And the cost to attend is $5, no advance purchase is necessary. And the Penn Street Market team would like to send their thanks to Pollen Consolidated for co-hosting with them, Oakbrook Brewery, and the Reading Downtown Improvement District for their help with making this event happen. Same weekend, Sunday, October 15th, is the Friends of the Reading Hospital Road Run. So the Reading Hospital Road Run features a scenic course that starts at the William Penn Memorial Fire Tower, and there's three different course options. You have a half marathon, a 5K, or a 1 mile run, where the participants can race past the historic pagoda, through City Park, and they finish up on Penn Street in downtown Reading. Proceeds from this run help to fund Friends of the Reading Hospital programs, such as their Heart Safe Berks County, telemedicine for stroke patients, assisting the Reading Recreation Commission. You can register for this event on their website, which you'll see on the screen here. It's rhroadrun.com up until the day before. And then another event, also the same weekend, Saturday, October 14th, is the Pumpkin Palooza at the GoggleWorks. And this event is held from 12 to 4 p.m. And we actually have Nova Harris here from the GoggleWorks as well, who's going to help to tell us a little bit about that.
Hi.
Hi. Hi, Nova.
Hi.
So you are the marketing director at the GoggleWorks, correct?
Yes, I am, yes.
And how long have you been in that role there?
I have been at GoggleWorks just 2 years this month.
Okay.
So 2 years now.
And what exactly does that entail? Because you have so much that happens there at the GoggleWorks. Classes and events
and
exhibits.
Marketing sort of touches everything that we do. We do year-round classes and workshops for ages 7 and up. We do an after-school arts program throughout the school year. We run summer camps in the summer. We do event rental spaces for anything from weddings to birthday parties, corporate events, small baby showers and the like. We have exhibitions. We have three galleries that turn exhibitions pretty regularly, usually monthly. We do monthly spotlight nights, which have open studios. We have 39 studio artists that work on the second and third floor of our building, and they come out during spotlight night with exhibition receptions and usually demonstrations. I'm probably forgetting things. We have a film theater that shows movies twice daily, 3 and 7. We also have a gift store that sells handcrafted items from artists around the country. a lot going
on. Yeah,
so
that's a really extensive list. And like you said, you're probably missing some things.
I'm sure I am.
So you're probably busy. And so, as I understand, the Pumpkin Palooza this year is the third year that you're running this event?
Yes. It's it was spawned, the brainchild of Jamie Smith and Scott Kronitsky. She's the director of administration, and Scott's our hot glass studio manager. Mm-hmm. We put together the event to sort of celebrate the start of the fall season, and we have glass pumpkins that we sell in the store, and they're really popular. We also run a lot of glass blowing workshops for people to come in and make their own pumpkin, so we just decided to try and make a family event around that and have a big sale and lots of activities for the community to come out.
Okay, so you mentioned glass blowing, pumpkin making day of. So how does that work that people are able to participate?
Sure, so we'll have out probably about 500 pumpkins for sale, mm-hmm. starting around $25 up to, we have
and
huge
range
ones.
In size.
Yes, ranging in size. If you'd like to make your own, then we sell 15-minute slots with the assistance of a studio artist who will be there. You get to pick your color and sort of they talk you through the whole process and you actually make your own pumpkin. It has to get fired and annealed in the cooled in the kiln, so you have to come back and pick it up usually within a week. We'll give you a call or we can ship it as well. Mm-hmm. But that's just another, more of an experiential time to make the pumpkin, sort of be in the studio. It's really popular. So, and it's ages 8 and up. If you're 8 to 12, if you just have to be accompanied by an adult.
Okay.
You can still do it.
And that's great. So you can walk in day of, sign up to do that.
We do have advanced sales beforehand. Mm-hmm. They're $40 a slot, and then $45 the day of.
Okay.
So people can get tickets purchased on site any time before the event. We're open 9 to 9 and also online on our website, GoggleWorks.org.
Okay. And I know also, so new this year for the Pumpkin Palooza is that we're doing a little partnership between GoggleWorks and the Downtown Improvement District.
So
we could talk a little bit about that. So the Downtown Improvement District is doing some of the kids' events this year.
Yes.
So we will be hosting free pumpkin painting for kids, and we're going to also have miniature scarecrow making and stuffing. And then you guys are going to be doing some kids' activities as well.
Yes, we will have face painting, and then we also we have a virtual reality artist on campus who will be doing. Kids can come in and do virtual reality pumpkin painting. And what else do we have? We have this gourd slingshot, so you pay $1 per shot. You can try and smash all the seconds from our glass studio. We set them up and do the slingshot. And then we're also going to be having some fire pits with s'mores, roasting marshmallows and making s'mores. We'll have apple cider tasting from a local cider, local orchard. And we'll have craft beer by Sly Fox Brewing Company. Mm-hmm. And I think we're having food trucks as well. Do you want to talk about those?
Yeah, we're going to be having some food trucks as well. One is a new restaurant, actually, in the Downtown Improvement District, the House of Jerk Dread. They're up in the 1000 block of Penn. They opened 2 months ago, and this will be their first event downtown.
Sweet.
Yeah.
We're also going to have live music from Peter Schneider Trio, their local band. And then we also have some like spooky photo ops a couple of our studio artists created on the campus so that you can stick your face in, become a Frankenstein or something.
Yeah.
So it should be fun.
So then that's Saturday, October 14th.
Yep. Admission is free. Parking is also free. Pumpkins are... come as, buy what you like
glass
or not.
Pumpkin. Yeah.
And all the kids' activities are free. Gourd slingshot, it does cost $1 per shot. Cider tasting and beer tasting are also free. So
great.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hope you come out.
Yeah, that's exciting. So there was a lot going on downtown the month of October and in general, and between Mi Casa, Su Casa, and the GoggleWorks, which is an easy 2-block radius, you could easily go back and forth between the two for food and activities and events and, well, thank you for joining us on Downtown Alive. And next month, look forward to us talking about the holiday parade as the holidays are coming up quickly and upon us. Thank you.